This is another edition of the doubleheader where we talk about the sport of politics and the politics of sport with Mark Shields and David Brooks before they get their makeup on, like the fancy pantses that they are. They go downstairs and talk politics. Okay, in the sport of politics
section.
Where's
my toupee, by the way?
Where's your toupee? in the sport of politics.
You can't get a mail order.
Mail order.
They don't work.
Keeping me focused.
Okay.
The hacking of the former First Family. Is probably not what you're going to talk about on the broadcast tonight, so we'll bring it up. I thought, well, first of all, we probably wouldn't be paying attention if it wasn't the First Family. People get hacked, emails get broken into, but this person clearly targeted the former Bushes, and it was, I think, Dorothy Bush, a sister of the former president. And you know, it was sad to see in some ways because you saw their personal life kind of splayed out in public. But the thing that's really picking up a lot of traction on the internet is apparently that George W. Bush is a painter, and he has painted himself in the bathroom, in the shower, and in the bathtub.
Yeah, watercolors.
What, you know? But then there was this other picture of him painting what looked like a chapel or something, which actually looked pretty good compared to the other two works.
They're getting good reviews online. I've noticed a lot of good reviews. Some art critic in New York said for a guy who has no talent, he's pretty good. Like he has no natural talent, but he wants to do it, and he's trying hard. I thought they looked pretty decent. Had a nice view of his back in one of the paintings. It's an odd thing to do, but actually, I took it as a great sign of contentment, of his basic health.
Okay.
But, you know, he wants to paint. And we've had some good painters. Churchill was a leader who was a genuinely good painter.
Okay.
Eisenhower was surprisingly a good painter. Bush, not quite in that league.
Yes.
But,
Tito was a...
Tito?
All right.
Really?
And what did you think?
Tito Jackson or Tito?
Tito Francona. But his is my take on it.
Okay.
Former presidents who feel that they haven't been successful as presidents devote an extraordinary amount of time, effort, energy to sort of rehabilitating their historical reputation. I mean, certainly Richard Nixon did that. Herbert Hoover was an exemplary public citizen. That's the pattern.
Is the inverse also true then?
Well, I think it tells you how somebody sees himself and his presidency. And certainly Bill Clinton devoted a lot of time to rehabilitate and has effectively rehabilitated his own reputation.
Yeah.
Exactly. And it's interesting to me because I've never understood where George W. Bush saw himself. And he's been an exemplary former president in the sense that he was totally circumspect, never criticized, no public utterances about Barack Obama throughout the campaign or anything of the sort. But I was kind of waiting for him to pick up a cause. And maybe he doesn't feel the need to do it. Maybe the library fulfills that.
But maybe he feels content.
He could feel content, and I think David's probably contributed to a sense of contentment.
There's that. All right, in the politics of sports segment, there was a winner and there was a loser last week, and the shoes are on the other foot. You had a horrible call about Notre Dame early in the season. We kind of let you slide.
But we have to remind
you. We do, and this time, however, you did say it would be within 3 points. It was within
3 points.
Three points. And
I said 24-21. It was 34-31.
Right.
Yep. And I've had people all over the country write and thank me for the prediction. People
here at the doubleheader.
That's right. People
and
who won the family pool, one person won enough to get parakeet, the surgery.
Right.
Needed,
yes, and you picked the Ravens.
Was that a sex change operation?
This is a G-rated show. Or PG. We're now going to get
you can't have a left wing and a right wing.
All right. But you, on the other hand, went with the San Francisco 49ers to pander to our enormously successful base, which I completely understood. They did not. Are you going to blame it on the blackout?
No, the blackout saved us.
Right.
You know, I make my sports predictions to make my political predictions look good. and I figure you can get one or the other. I'm going to get my political predictions right. So the sports predictions, just for foil, just to contrast.
Wait, you do have makeup on.
I do. Thank you for noticing.
Did you think San Francisco was going to win when they had that surge?
They're down. They're in the 8-yard line.
Oh, yeah.
They got four plays. They've run down the field.
Yeah. I mean, come on. You got to tell me that was holding.
That was holding.
In the end zone. Once you crossed the end zone, that was
my question. They've got this guy who is a physical wonder, Kaepernick, whatever you say about him.
Right.
Okay.
Sure.
and why well, they were down there. They didn't once try and run him to the outside.
Or they're starting running back.
Yeah, or they're starting running back. He's got a stride that's like a 220
the
yard
fix was in.
Gold yeah. medal winner. Yeah. No, obviously, but I mean, why do you throw? I mean, there's no place for maneuvering in the end zone.
Yeah.
I mean, there really isn't. I mean, I just couldn't understand why they didn't try and isolate him with on a linebacker. And I tell you, he'd outrun anybody.
Yeah, I think the coach is choked. I would say I thought the right Harbaugh one.
I agree with you.
Sideline demeanor.
You're absolutely right. I think John Harbaugh was the more emotionally healthy of the two. And no, he was far more appealing. Jim was a little wired. He doesn't fit San Francisco.
No. Oakland. They should trade him to Oakland.
Maybe.
No, just across the bay. He's a Silicon Valley guy.
Moving.
You think they're tight? They're tight.
Little cappuccinos here and there. All right. That note will have to end this edition of the Doubleheader. I'm Harry Srinivasan from our Shields, David Brooks. Thanks for joining us.